good morning, everyone. As Alan said, this was one of the largest press releases by testimonials in W3C history. Why is this? So before we go into why everyone's excited about this, and the names on the press release were people like US federal government agencies, the European Commission, global trade organizations, right? It's a big deal. But first of all, what's a verifiable credential? For those of you that are not familiar with verifiable credentials, they're basically a privacy-preserving technology for issuing, storing, and presenting things like education degrees, government-issued ID cards, shipping container manifests, certified product information, and other machine-readable credentials. You can think about them as the things in your physical wallet today, digitized and put online, with you in control of when to share them. Decentralized identifiers, another W3C standard now, is a new identifier technology that's based on cryptography that empowers us to control our personal data and consent to its usage. DIDs are often used with verifiable credentials. There's an example of what a DID looks like, fairly simple thing. Now, why is everyone excited about this stuff? If we look at deployment and funding, right, the real demonstration of whether or not these standards are useful in the world is people are putting real money behind them. U.S. Customs and Border Protection, and you'll hear more about this later on, has just committed to using verifiable credentials and decentralized identifiers in their next generation trade systems. That's $2.3 trillion of goods flowing into and out of the US. That is happening in other nation states as we speak. Europe has funded the European Digital Wallet Initiative. It's actually a number of initiatives to the tune of $163 million just this year, covering around 450 million people using verifiable credentials and decentralized identifiers. VCs are being used for digital education across the US, across the EU, and in places like Uganda, Nigeria, and Kenya, covering 323 million people. There's a new digital age verification program that's going live in the United States. It uses verifiable credentials, covers 152,000 retail locations, 50 million age checks a day using verifiable credentials, 200 million people a year, total population. There are organizations like Adobe adopting verifiable credentials for their content authenticity initiative to make sure that images and videos not tampered after they're created. That's going into Photoshop, 30 million customers just in Adobe alone. Other content providers, content creators are putting this into their technology stacks. And finally, just last week, US Citizenship and Immigration Services in the United States just announced that they will be using verifiable credentials and decentralized identifiers for their next generation digital permanent resident card. These are fairly significant numbers, demonstrating fairly strong adoption of the technology. We're still early days. There are many more announcements like this that we're expecting over the next year. We are a growing community at W3C. We have the Verifiable Credentials Working Group, the Decentralized Identifiers Working Group, and the Credentials Community Group, which over the last 10 years has grown to 500 plus people, 100 plus companies, collaborating with organizations like the Decentralized Identity Foundation, the OpenID Foundation, the Trust Over IP Foundation, the Linux Foundation, the Internet Identity Workshop, Rebooting the Web of Trust, and a variety of other venues that are global, all working to deploy verifiable credentials to a global audience. We're just beginning. The work's not done. We have many challenges ahead of us. The Verifiable Credentials 2.0 work is underway at W3C. So please join us. If this stuff interests you, if you want a web that respects individual privacy, if you want a web that empowers individual consent, and if you want a web that lives up to its full potential, Please join us and help us. Thank you.